Welcome back, everybody. We're here to start our next portion of our journey in Endless Ocean. I wonder what we'll find today. So excited. Choose the clock on the cabin to advance to the morning, okay? Let's mess with some of the volume settings here. I know the music is great, but that's kind of intense. I was told to come into the boat, check out the clock to make it daytime, and then we could proceed. So let's proceed until morning. And then we have a mail somewhere, so let's check out and see what's in the mail today. Ooh, Aubrey Thorman. I can handle requests for diving guides in the Manoa Lai. I've requested for you to act as a diving guide. The client's name is Will Gain, and he's pretty valued client. Oh, is this the guy we already... Yeah, I think this is the guy we've already helped. New swimwear diving report. This letter is in regard to your recent performance as a diving guide. Oh boy. He was kind of cranky. 4 stars out of 5. He was very happy with the experience you provided, and the foundation is pleased. Please keep up the good work. P.S. Hey, nice. I bet you won't be too long before you're considered the top guide. Thanks, Aubrey. Thanks. Let's just, gear's already good. Encyclopedia. I wonder if we can pilot the boat somewhere. Go to the blue hole. The blue hole. So these videos will be roughly about an hour because as I mentioned in my last video, I can only record up to an hour and edit it with the current software I have, so we'll do hour increment chunks. I know you're going to do great things today. All right, let's see what we find. Yes. Let's go diving. Let's go diving. Let's see what we can find. Exciting. The loads, I think this is probably one of the top tier load screens that are not boring and pretty to look at. Let me know what you think, or if I'm completely wrong, this is a boring load screen, but I think for most, considering this isn't so bad. All right. It's a school of blue tangs. Yeah, powder blues. Cute. I wonder what else we can discover around here. We've seen some of the angels. Maybe there's some treasure down here. I believe the tabletops have some type of interesting creatures in them. Maybe wrong though. But there's the chromas again. I wonder if... Come here, little friend. I think they're... underwater pen. Wait, someone was telling me that riding with it attracts different creatures, like doing different things, so I'm gonna try. This is interesting. I am not sure what I'm supposed to do with that, but Maybe I can draw on it? Did it like it? Maybe not. There is something on top of the table shelf, Coral, though. Let's check it out. What is here? Do we need to be closer? Oops. Ooh, a seahorse. Now I think there's some more. I think those are species of Chromis or Dotties. I have to get a better look. Wonder feed. Crown seahorse, nice. Ooh. Sapphire devil. Neat, we found a few more species. Ooh. I feel like I always consider it like driving a character. It's still a little wonky for me. Especially because I'm playing, ooh, with a controller on in like emulation. Emperor Angel. We saw one of these last time. Oh, hi. Hi. You hungry? I got food? That's really neat that it came up to me like that. I do remember them saying that they'd become more friendly, which is pretty cool. But I didn't know it meant like legitimately would come and swim up to you. That's neat. Alright, I want to discover new species. But I'm not sure how to do that. Unless we discover a new area, which I think you just have to swim to the area to discover. I guess we'll find out. Hi, friend. Good to see you. I think it went away. Some clown triggers. Sailfin tangs. I'll have to post a picture of my aquarium I have at home and show you my sailfin tang. They are beautiful. It's not, it roughly resembles the one here in the game. The species that I have is a Desjardini. So it's a sailfin, so like I've been saying, but also it has deep yellow and black stripes going vertically across the body, which makes it very, very visually appealing. Ooh. I think these have the stripes, but they're not as brightly colored, and that just may be because these are natural, supposed to be natural fish. I'm not sure if my tang was aquacultured or not. Let's see. Oh, interesting. Oh, that's a wrasse. Looks like we're going, yeah, back to the area we've already been in. Hi, friend. Welcome back. So cute. The fish just wants to come hang out with me. We shall name him Flounder. He will be our friend. Just want to discover new areas. Okay, okay. I have a feeling I might have to go back to the boat to do something. Like, to unlock it. Or maybe I just need to discover more species. But I feel like I would have seen some, or maybe I need to level up my relationship with said species. This Emperor Angel really is truly becoming my best friend. Or wants me to feed it again. Usually animals want you to feed them. Come here, come here. Am I just too far? There we go. Teardrop butterfly. Let's give it some food. Yeah, maybe the emperor was hungry. He is going ham on that fish food. Nice. Is that a copper band? Oh, now you're my friends too. So great. There is a copper band. Wait, wait. Wait. That's so difficult. Okay, well, we'll come back. There's yellow tangs. I believe I found these the last playthrough. Yeah. Might as well feed them as well. Yeah. The Emperor's just like, I want you to feed me. We feed me and we will be best friends. Same. Feed me, we shall be friends. I love that. Okay, let's see if there's something in the boat, because I want to do something more than just search for creatures we've already seen. But we'll see where it takes us. I wonder if the X is where we need to go. I have a feeling it is. Or that's where it's taking us? I don't know. New mail, that's usually a good sign. Gives me something to do. Yes, a diving request. We have a request from Michael Schaff. You would like to explore the lagoon. Let us know if you can fulfill the request within 7 days. If we get a positive reply, we'll send the client to you. Reply. Yes. The lagoon is where he wants to visit or to dive at. Yes. I wonder if he's going to be cranky like the other guy. Or if it'll be something fun. I wonder what he wants to see. There's always a catch, right? The music is so chill. It's nice. Oh, here they come. Hello, my name is Michael Schaff. Yeah, we know. I'm a veterinarian from Germany. Interesting. I specialize in treating mammals. It is a pretty narrow field of study. Not nowadays, that's for damn sure. You're new, right? Well, it's really nice to meet you. I was reading a diving magazine, and now I have to see one thing. A pyramid butterfly fish. Okay. Okay. That's the one thing I want to see more than anything. So, in my studies, one of my professors in one of my courses, he is both a PhD for humans, but he's a veterinarian as well. And his primary field of study is healing and doing surgeries and conservation work for sea turtles. So the class that I took was called Sea Turtle Rehabilitation. And let me tell you, that was the most interesting class I've taken so far, and I really loved it. The professor travels all over the world educating different people about species of turtles and different diseases that they contract. And let me tell you, it was really cool. If you guys care to want to know more about it, I'd love to share what I've learned. But until then, we're looking for a pyramid butterfly fish. Pretty sure this is a copper band. If I can, you know, Oh, that's a long nose, not a copper band. Ooh, look at all these little ones. So cute. Oh. Let's see. Oh, it's a Mandarin Goby. These are awesome. Wait, no, go back. Push the wrong button. Mandarin Gobies are beautiful. Let's see if we can pet them. No. How about food? Will food get you to like me? Yay! Green Mandarin Goby. The blue ones, I've seen in person, and they're stunning. They're this vibrant, like, almost electric blue. The green ones are pretty, too. They're just not as visually stunning. Testing, testing. Can you hear me? Is everything going well? Uh-oh. You still haven't found it. Try harder. You know, these people are very demanding. Can't they just enjoy the beauty that is around them instead of being jerks? Pyramid of butterfly fish. You say. Moorish idol. Nope. And then we have the ray! Ugh, so pretty. I need to find this fish, though, before the guy loses his mind. Oh, there's something else over here, though. Huh. Dang it. I think it's like hold B, then press A, something like that. Hold A, press B. Hold A, press B. Help if I remembered how to take the item. Got it. Sorry, guy. Back to the search. Pyramid angelfish. Where is it? Where is a pyramid butterfly fish? I don't know, sir. We're looking, okay? Pyramid butterfly fish. I feel like it was that yellow one. I can't think of what they look like off the top of my head. Oh, this might be it. This might be it. Is food the way to your heart, friend? It's not. Oh. About like drawing. Something about drawing. Is this it? Is this... I really want to find a pyramid butterfly. Is that not what this is? I need to know what it is, though. It's going to bother me. I need to know. Come on, man. Oriental butterfly fish. That might have said ornamental. I might be a tad dyslexic. Okay. Pyramid butterfly fish. It's a long nose. Nope. Man. Oh, that's the Goby again. Pyramid butterfly fish. I think we might fail this one. since I can't think of what it looks like and I'm not seeing it. Oh, is that it? Huh. That's what I wanted to see. Cool, let's feed your friends. I feel like that was a lot easier than I was making it. Pyramid butterfly fish. I guess they ate shoal, so that'll be easier to find it in the future. I want to become a kind vet who can help these guys. Manta rays. Be pretty cool. Ooh. I can't wait to tell my friends about this. What, that you're with the ray? I'm just looking for treasure and cool fish, my guy. Oh. It usually means there's something good. Well, oh, here's something. I wonder if it's another Goby. Oh, it's not. What are you? Very interesting. Feed? No? It's gone. Where did you go? I'm not sure what this... I really will eventually figure out what this pen does. And when we do, I feel like it'll be glorious. Look how vast the ocean is. We're about to... We are a tiny speck compared to it. Yeah, yeah. And I'd like to find out what this little tiny speck is. I guess we're not meant to do that yet. Come on. You plank dead. Ooh, five-lined coral goby. I've never seen one of these before. It's pretty neat. Okay, let's go up, return to the boat, and get our grade. See what this guy thinks. He said he enjoyed seeing what he saw. So maybe he'll leave us a good review. Or maybe not. What do you think, Triton? What do you think, Triton? Just happy bounces. That was so much fun. You're a wonderful guide. I hope to pair up with you again sometime soon. Okay, that's like our favorite thing. The okay. Okay. New mail. Awesome. Let's check it out. New gloves? You're doing an exceptional job out there. Everyone at the foundation thinks more and more of you by the day. Well, isn't that nice? To reward you for your efforts, I am sending you some new equipment, and I am sure you will put it to good use. Let's see the loot. What'd we get? Gear. Gloves? So we've got blue gloves, yellow gloves. I think we'll stick with, why not? We'll just do yellow, sure. It'll stand out in case of emergencies. Hmm. I wonder if we can go night diving. I feel like we can, but maybe just not yet. I wonder what we'll find at night. Maybe we can dive at night. Let's see. Oh, well. Yeah, it looks like we can't go night diving yet. Dang. On a night dive. I've actually done night snorkeling, and it was such an amazing adventure. I snorkeled in Jamaica, and we saw a bunch of jellyfish and rock lobster and, oh my goodness, urchin and like little invertebrates. Not little, they were actually pretty big, but they were invertebrates, and it was just really cool. Really, really cool. Four stars out of five. Top guide. Okay. There's enough light to now go diving. We're gonna do great things today. Yeah, we'll see. I wanna go somewhere new. That dolphin looked like it was headed for the lagoon. Well, that's probably what we need to do is do some more reconnaissance with the dolphin. Come on now. Let's dive at the lagoon. I wonder if I needed to move my boat first. I might have needed to move my boat first. Oh my goodness. I have two small kids, so if you hear me like humming Bluey, just know that I am stuck forever in the Bluey mindset. However, it could be worse. I actually enjoy that show, other than other children's shows that drive me nuts. Ooh, dolphin. Dolphino. Oh, that's a dolphin. That dolphin. I think he's stuck in the lagoon. Dolphins use a kind of sonar called echolocation to navigate. It works like a radar dish, sending out signals and then getting them back. But shallow water like this can cause them problems. They have trouble figuring out where they are. And in the worst case scenario, they can become stranded. Now I'm worried for the poor little guy. We have to help him. Well, we will do our best. I really want to know if we can... Ooh, maybe? Oh, the Goby again. We don't need to see the Goby. I wonder if we just need to show it out. Oh, hey! So cute! Hey, I think the dolphin is following you. Let's lead him to the coral forest. Let's go. I think it's this way. Yeah, it is. That's neat. I didn't know you can go into like full first person mode. Yeah. Come on, dolphin. Let's save you and get you out of the lagoon that you are trapped in. You did it! He escaped the lagoon. Oh. I think the dolphin likes you. I'm not surprised. Not after how you just helped him. Dolphins are very sentient creatures. You can just dive at your leisure now. Come back to the Gambiano when you are ready and tired. I wonder if I can feed it and become better friends with it. I would imagine so. Can't pet it. Oh, there we go. Ooh. Pyramid. I don't need those. Wait. Where is the dolphin? Where did the dolphin? Oh, there it is. Wait. Wait. Come back, Flipper. Come back, Flipper. There we are. I wonder if I can feed this one too. No, I know you don't eat that stuff, but... Yes, chirp chirp. Okay, maybe it's not meant for that. Not meant for us yet. I wonder who we'll have to help search for next. Like, what person's going to want to dive with us. Manoa Lai. It's a pretty little, not really an estuary, but almost. Welcome back. That was pretty amazing, by the way. I've never seen a wild dolphin act so friendly. Not even towards me. Huh? Oh, never mind. Anyway, the people of the Pelagio love dolphins. Long ago, they thought that they were holy messengers of a sort. It trusts you now, so make sure you're nice to it. I couldn't work with someone who wouldn't respect animal life. Oh yeah, here, take this. Ooh, an underwater whistle. I'm assuming to call the dolphin. It's an underwater whistle, what you've never seen one before. Like you've never seen one before. You can use it to communicate with marine animals. Yeah, these are all the rage with the hip, young marine biologist crowd. Cringe. That feels a little cringe. But I know this game is older, so... It's dated. The cool thing is that it sounds same above or below water. Try using it to signal dolphins. You want to give it a try? Use the stern to access training point where you can interact with your partner, okay? The pingus. I think the stern is up here. Maybe it's in the back. Gaze at the ocean. Listen to music. MP3 files. Oh, that's really interesting. That's really interesting. Why not sit and enjoy the good life? So peaceful. Well, where's this toy thing? Gaze at the ocean. Huh. Oops, wrong button. Let's see. Still only those few locations. Oop, wait, there is a new mail. Japanese bullhead shark spawning. Interesting. During this time of year, the Japanese bullhead sharks gather in Manoa Lai coastal waters to spawn. Our data indicates that spawning is now occurring around the G5 area of your map. Ooh, let's go see some bullhead sharks. Perhaps you should sail over and take a look for yourself. I'm sure it would prove to be fascinating. This sounds exciting already. So G5? How do we sail there? Oh! I thought you could only explore areas that were green. The world has opened. Yes, that's awesome! Okay. That makes so much more sense. I was just waiting to be like, okay, when are we going to uncover more of the map? Because I want to explore more of the map. Little did I know, I just needed to choose where I wanted to go. You know, because things are hard that way. I'm glad we figured it out. I want to see those bullhead sharks. Time to go. Oh, can we not dive? Or do I just need to be further away? Ooh. Boo. try going down to the going down the gangplank. That creature might come to you. What? Gangplank. Okay. Very interesting whistle. Aww. It's so cute! Hi, friends. Hey, it actually worked. I thought for sure it was going to be bogus. Great, why don't you give your partner a name? Oh, wait. Let me give you some name ideas. I'm good at this. Snowy? What do you think? You don't like it? Well then, what kind of name did you have in mind? Oh, I have to spell this thing now. I'm gonna give it a very classic, classy name. And I'm sure you all may already know. Flipper. What else could we name it, of course? Only the most appropriate dolphin movie name ever. If you haven't seen Flipper, go watch it. It's a very good movie. Oh, hey, that's really good. But while you're at it, how about teaching your partner a trick? Ooh, okay. Oh, there's multiple. You could have multiple pets, partners. Point to your partner's mouth or fin and press A. Release it, then press it again while moving the Wii remote in that direction. This will give him a command. Give your partner directional commands, okay? Once your partner learns your hand sign, release A, and then shake the controller to give the go sign. Your partner will perform each time you give it a sign. I don't remember what I had tagged to the... Check my controls. I don't remember what I mapped the swing to. Shake the egg. Yeah, I wonder why it's not working. Oh. Okay, I didn't have them mapped. Let's see. Let's try again. Let's try again. Perform the technique, shake the Wii remote to display the Go icon. Okay, I think we got it. Whee! Wow, that's really good. Oh wait, he's trying to say something. Is that all you got, pal? Hey, don't look at me, I'm just a translator. Hey, kind of fun, right? Directing your partner like this can be a great experience. The more you practice, the closer you will get. And if you do well, your partner's tricks will evolve and change. But that's really up to you, so keep training. Okay, so I need to like... Okay. And I just keep pressing it, I think. Okay. Okay, well, we'll work on that later. Dive with my partner. Cool. That's a fun little nugget. I wonder what other partners you can have, if there are other dolphins or if there's like other creatures. I would love to like dive with an octopus, like have an octopus or something funky as a partner. That'd be really cool. Oh, you went diving with your partner. You can call your partner with your whistle. It might not work perfectly at first, but the more familiar you are, the quicker he will respond. Okay, cool. I want to go find these sharks. That sounds really exciting. Bullhead shark spawning grounds should be in this area. Yeah. They're in the square that I've pinned. There they are! Or is it my dolphin? That's my dolphin, never mind. Just kidding. I wonder if they're deeper. Way down here. Ooh, look at that Gigas clam. That's huge. The giant Maxima. Most often, though, they're blue. So it's neat to see them. It's not, I wouldn't say neat. Maybe it's just more so interesting to see them that color than neat. I've cultured a couple of Maxima clams in my day, and I think they're just so beautiful. Are there... I don't see them. Oh, another Maxima clam. I'm barely in the right area. Let's go back up. I wonder if we came out too early. Maybe too late. Or I need to go further up again on to where the shelf is. Doesn't seem to be much here. Were we led astray? Like, that's a circle. I'm going in circles. Here it is! We found them! Nice. They look very catfishy, but that's neat, I guess. Japanese bullhead shark. Let's feed them. They freeze. Interesting, huh? They seem pretty stagnant. Oh, what just happened? Rock Bluff. Feels a little ominous. I don't know how I feel about that. Oh, look at that big, big mama? I'm assuming it's a female since this is a spawning ground. Is that a hammerhead? It is! Scalloped hammerhead. So their head is slightly more concave than more traditional hammerheads. Can I feed you? Can we be friends? What is that? What is this? Who are you? Oh, that thing's neat. What are you? What are you? Come on, I want to discover you. The bowmouth guitarfish. You hungry? No. I'm sure it's more of a predator. Surely, right? That's really cool. Wow, that was neat. We found some hammerhead sharks. We found bullhead sharks. A guitarfish, a goby. Today's been really eventful of finding new species. You know, now that I know how to actually move my boat and venture new waters. It only took me an episode to figure it out. I wonder if there's any small creatures we could find. I thought there might be one in here, but the difficulty of figuring it out. Oh, okay. Oh, I really did leave the target dive area, geez. Turn around. Really want to find some other species. Let's see. Maybe one more. May not be new. I know this is like fan coral. Typically there wouldn't be anything moving or growing fish-wise out of it. But this is a video game. We could be surprised. Maybe there'll be something in this coral. Grain coral, stalagma coral. What else? Some more of our fanfish. Sail fins. I think that's all. Other than these clams and coral. So I don't think there's anything else other than what we've seen in this area. To be discovered. Let's see if I can befriend the bicolor parrotfish. Yeah, I did see the comment about someone saying it's a little more muted or not totally authentic to how it's supposed to be, and I see that. But given the age of the game, you know, I feel like it's acceptable. Oops. Wonder if I... Ooh, page 2. And did we get page 3? Not yet. Males, females, and fry all differ in color. Fry are white and orange stripe on their heads, while females are yellow with black on the edges of their scales. Neat. I like how they give you, it's almost very dorky of me, like considering it like a Pokédex, because it gives you tidbits of information to kind of help you identify the species and then what seems like to sex them. I heard something. Where is that sparkly sound? Am I just going crazy? I thought the sparkly sound means that you'd found something. Maybe not. Alright, well, let's go back to the boat. We're nearing our 1 hour mark. I think we found a lot of really cool stuff. Sharks, the story with the dolphin, I'm really excited about that. I need to figure out how to get the controls to work properly so then I can actually do some of the tricks with it. I've actually been considering getting an actual Wii remote to use this with, but I would have to get a dongle to use the bar. But that's something I'm thinking about. I think it could be a lot of fun. We'll see. So I want to be able to play this game to its intended full potential because I really am enjoying it. Rats, this is bad. This is really, really bad. Uh-oh. What's going on, squirrel friend? Don't sneak up on me like that. Huh? What's wrong with me? Oh, I don't know. I've got a problem. See, the aquarium and the mainland is opening next month, and they asked me to help coordinate the main tank display. You know, like which fish to put in it and there and so on, but doing that means I'd have to get inside the tank, and that would be a whole lack of swimming ability and all. Just isn't going to work. Double rats. I gotta find someone who knows about the ocean, but they also need extensive diving experience. I wonder who that would be. Catherine, you're an idiot. Yeah, thanks, Catherine. I know you are. What am I talking about? I am talking about the aquarium. A person who knows about the ocean with extensive diving experience? That's you! You'd be perfect. What do you think? The aquarium is in Kaia? I'm going to pronounce it the best I can. On the Pelagio mainland. I put you on the map in the cabin in case you're interested. You can just sail to the Gambiano right there. So whenever you're ready, just grab the steering wheel and go. Nice. It's the perfect place to stop. Next time, we will do some more free diving and then check out the aquarium. And we have mail. Let's get to the aquarium, open the map by clicking on the wheel, then choose the small island on the top left hand of the map. I'm counting on you to place the fish properly in the aquarium. I heard you, but we're not doing that right now. Let's save. Well, until next time, we're going to enjoy what we've seen so far, and then when we come back next episode, we are going to go to the aquarium and search for more species. Thank you so much for joining me for episode 2, and I'm looking forward to seeing you in episode 3.